Hi friends, myself Neha, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin this video of Morning Tales for December 14, 2020 without wasting any time. But the students who are coming for the first time can subscribe our channel and hit this bell notification so that you guys can get instant updates about our new uploads. Also here on this Telegram channel, we resolve the queries of students as well as we provide free quizzes. So if you want to attempt quizzes, you can join this Telegram channel and the link is in description box below. So here is our first question. Which state has signed the first of its kind MOU with the Survey of India for taking up the land survey? So this MOU that a state among the options has signed with the Survey of India is one of its kind. And what is the purpose of this MOU? The purpose is to conduct the land survey. And what is the benefit of conducting land survey? It will help in demarcation of land and land titling. So that is the purpose of this MOU. Now which state has done so? It is Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh has signed this MOU with Survey of India. Recently SEBI has signed an MOU with Financial and commissioned the surveillance due sector financial. Which country does CSSF belong to? So this organization is the financial regulator of which country? Among the options which has Netherlands, Finland, Germany, Luxembourg and Denmark, the right answer is option D, Luxembourg. So this is the financial regulator of Luxembourg, and with this organization, Securities and Exchange Board of India, that is SEBI, has signed an MOU in order to strengthen cooperation in financial sector. So basically in order to improve their capacity and quality of supervision in the securities market, this MOU has been signed between these two organizations. So guys, as I always say that whenever we are talking about any kind of new country or any country, we should keep in mind the static portion about Luxembourg. So this is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section. What is the capital and what is the currency of Luxembourg? With which country has India signed an MOU for technology cooperation in the road infrastructure sector? So we have been given 5 options: UK, USA, Singapore, Austria and Japan. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is Austria. So with Austria, this MOU has been signed. Under this MOU, both the countries will share technology and expertise in the field of road infrastructure to build resilient roads. Now guys, do you remember that what is the target of India to become the to have zero road fatalities? By which year does India want to have zero road fatalities? I have discussed it in one of the previous morning tale session. So I expect an answer from you guys in the comment section below. So do not forget to mention the year by which India aims to achieve the zero road fatalities. Again, it's a country, so capital and currency are the static facts related to Austria that you should remember. And we have discussed such facts earlier in the sessions. I have asked you similar questions previously as well. So this is to remind you all the facts that you have already told me in the comment section, that this is the currency, this is the capital of Austria, this is the currency and this is the capital of Luxembourg and whatever country we are discussing in the session. Now we have our next question. Which state has unveiled the Shakti Act to curb crimes against women and children? So first of all, this Shakti Act is a bill right now that has been approved by the state cabinet, but the legislative assembly of the state in question has not passed it yet. So basically this will be presented to the session, to the assembly in the winter session. So this act is at present is a bill, and it has been made on the lines of Disha bill that we have in Andhra Pradesh. So Disha bill is claimed to be the first ever bill at the state level for the protection of women and children. So it was introduced in the year 2019 and this Shakti Act has been introduced in 2020. Now, which state has introduced it? It is Maharashtra. So, remember this thing that Maharashtra has unveiled this Shakti Act and there are high chances that it can be passed in the winter session of the state assembly. Next question is, which country is the chair of ASEAN in 2021? So, this announcement was made during the ASEAN Defense Ministers Ministerial Meeting, 14th edition of this meeting. So, it was recently held and Indian Defense Minister Rajnath Singh attended this meeting. Now, here the chair of ASEAN 2021 was announced and the right answer for this question is option E, Brunei. So this is the country that is going to chair ASEAN, the 10 member bloc in 2021. And what is the theme of ASEAN for 2021? It is Prosper. So this is the theme of ASEAN in 2021 and the chair is Brunei Darussalam. Now guys, what is this ASEAN Defense Ministerial Meeting Plus? So this is basically a grouping or a meeting of 10 member ASEAN group along with 8 countries. So this plus stands for additional 8 countries and these 8 countries group also include India. So that's all for this question. Now your task is to name the total 10 country members of ASEAN grouping. So this is your homework for the day that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Who among the following has won the FICCI Sportsperson of the Year name? So FICCI has recently announced the India Sports Awards. And there, this FICCI Sportsperson of the Year award was organized for both male and female categories. Now the question is asking you about the male. So the right answer is option C, Bajrang Punia. Now guys, which sport does he belong to? He is a wrestler. Remember his sport as well, that he is a wrestler. And he has won this FICCI Sportsperson of the Year award 2020. Now in this slide, you can see the categories of the awards as well as the winners. So FICCI Sportsperson of the Year in female category has been won by Evanil Valarivan, who is a shooter. Best state for promoting sports, Madhya Pradesh. Best company promoting sports in the private sector, Tenvik Sports. This is a company of Anil Kumble. So this company has won this award. Coach of the Year has been won by Radhakrishnan Nair, who is from the field of athletics. Best National Sports Federation, Wrestling Federation of India, Paralympic Committee of India. Best Para Athlete, male, Sundar Singh Gujjar, who is a javelin thrower, shot putter and discus thrower. Best Para Athlete, female, Simran Sharma, who is an athlete. So these are the other awardees of this award. Which country will host the Asia Cup cricket in 2022? So, this Asia Cup is organized under the ambit of ACC, that is Asia Cricket Council. So, this ACC Council organizes or we can say regulates this Asia Cup cricket and in 2021 it will be held by Sri Lanka and in 2022 it is Pakistan. Option A, Pakistan, and in 2021 it is Sri Lanka. So remember the host countries for both the editions. Now guys, it's time for me to bid adieu to you. I hope that you have really enjoyed the session and if you have, then do share it with your friends and do come back for tomorrow's session as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.